We have a predator that came from the depths of the cosmos and took over the rule of our lives. Human beings are its prisoners. The predator is our lord and master. It has rendered us docile, helpless. If we want to protest, it suppresses our protest. If we want to act independently, it demands that we don't do so. Something is holding us prisoners. They took us over because we are food for them, and they squeeze us mercilessly because we are their substance. Just as we rear chickens in the chicken coops, the predators rear us in human coops, humaneros. Their food is always available to them. Sorcerers believe that the predators have given us our systems of belief, our ideas of good and evil, our social mores. They are the ones who set up our hopes and expectations and dreams of success or failure. They have given us covetousness, greed, and cowardice. It is the predators who make us complacent, routinary, and egomaniacal. In order to keep us obedient and meek and weak, the predators engage themselves in a stupendous maneuver, stupendous, of course, from the point of view of a fighting strategist. A horrendous maneuver from the point of view of those who suffer it. They gave us their mind. Do you hear me? The predator give us their mind, which becomes our mind. The predator's mind is baroque, contradictory, morose. The predators inject into the lives of human beings whatever is convenient for them. And they ensure, in this manner, a degree of security to act as a buffer against their fear.
Perfect human world, where none suffered, where everyone would be happy.
Sure, like the mind parasites, they thrive on negativity and weave hallucinations to confound the mind. But they also create beguiling wonder and synthetic paradises for their victims, namely all of humanity. Why is that? Because their primary purpose is to keep the essence of Sophia that fuels creation itself scattered across matter. We are that scattered essence, the divine spark, kept in a state of ignorance from this truth via both negative and positive machinations. Ignorance is the ultimate goal, the essence of Sophia the ultimate prize. The Archons like us to love our smartphones as much as they want us to be afraid to take up a new hobby that might improve our lives.
Our impulses are being redirected. We are living in an artificially induced state of consciousness that resembles sleep. They have made us indifferent to ourselves, to others. We are focused only on our own gain.
That epigenetic plasma enveloping our souls that forces all of our bad decisions and, yes, even bad thoughts.
Choice is an illusion created between those with power and those without.
Furthermore, madness is the consort of the Demiurge, as well as the mother of all the Archons. And she demands worship as much as Yali Bali. These predators are real, and here we are, at the end of the world, now fighting mind parasites, along with Egregore's Archons and alien robots named Pandora. The Empire never ended, and neither have the voices in my head.